Well, we have this very unique resource here at the Springs Preserve and in the Spring Mound. And there's probably about 27, 26 or so spring mounds found throughout the Las Vegas Valley. And to have one on our property is a special and unique situation.
And it loomed even larger in the life of this environment when it was a verdant and spring-fed setting.
Because they were a source of water, there was a lot of attraction to animals, a lot of attraction to people, to these spring mounds. So there was always a lot of cultural activity, not just by people, but also by animals and the plant growth. And so it was quite an attraction to bring people to these spring mounds.
Still today, the surroundings are rich with evidence of the spring mound's role as a hunting and picnic ground, practically paved with pieces of tools and weapons, pots and fire pits left behind by historic and prehistoric Native Americans.
There was activity happening on the spring mound going back thousands of years all the way through probably to contact with European settlers. The oldest artifacts that we've actually recovered from the Las Vegas Springs Preserve, from our property here, come from the surface of the Spring Mound. And these are things that are mostly late archaic period.
But as old as the site and its artifacts are, both are worth surveying for new finds again and again.
We've done surveys on these spring mounds before, and like anywhere else in any sort of cultural area where people have lived for thousands of years, you're going to find artifacts on the surface. And so every few years it makes sense to go back and resurvey areas that you've already been over, because over time, as rain falls, as wind blows, more and more artifacts become uncovered. So the last time we did a full-scale survey of the spring mound was probably about 2007. And so we're looking to update our maps, update our information, and update the types of artifacts that we find on the spring mound here.
And the current survey benefited immensely because a team of eager archaeology students were able to use tried and true methods, along with the latest technology, to map the artifacts they found.
I'm teaching an archaeological field methods class at UNLV, and mostly it's classroom-based, but we wanted to have an opportunity where we could bring the students out into the field and actually do some real archaeological work. So none of the students had any experience really in the field before. So this was the first time that they were able to find archaeological remains in situ, so in the ground. We started off by spacing ourselves out along the edge of this survey area here, and each student had a bunch of flags in their hands. So we walk across the terrain, looking at the ground to see if we find anything. A student just found a projectile point, so an arrowhead, just a few minutes ago. So we'll flag that. And then what we do, once we have a whole bunch of flags in the ground, we'll use the total station up here, which is basically a mapping tool, so we can map in the location of each artifact that we've encountered in survey. But this morning we found about 350 artifacts in about 20 minutes. So that tells you how dense the material here is. And it's going to be a big job, but the students are having a really good time, so that's what it's all about.
For the archaeologists as well, the array of structures and utensils provides a rewarding view of the ancient humans who lived here.
The artifacts that we found during the survey are exactly what you would expect to find from a habitation of people living in a spot for a long period of time. We have projectile points, of course, that we found. We have the hearths, the roasting pits, the thermal features. We also have pieces and parts of ceramics from different time periods, going back to the ancestral Pueblo and all the way through to the Paiute period. We also find parts of grinding stones that would have been used for processing seeds, mesquite pods, corn, any other sort of vegetable matter that you would have ground into a flour. We find some of those here as well.
But they've still only scratched the surface of the Spring Mound's potential revelations and are hoping to dig deeper into its hidden possibilities.
We know that other spring mounds in the valley, they've found mammoth, bison, camel, early horse have been recovered from those. And we don't exactly know how old our spring mound is. We don't exactly know if we have any of these large megafauna that are located in there. And so ultimately, the survey that we're doing now will lead us to future work, hopefully some larger scale testing, so we could actually do some excavations into that spring mound and answer some of those questions.
But for now, they're looking forward to showing these artifacts to modern visitors, who will undoubtedly find in them a greater understanding of the people who used to make the Spring Mound one of the earliest gathering places at the preserve.